Today I will show you how to create batch logo design in Inkscape. Let's begin. Okay, first let's make some circle with stroke only in here. Go to your circle tool and press Ctrl Shift to make it proportional scale. Make it as stroke only, just swap it, right click, just swap fill and stroke. So it will make it into stroke. Then adjust the thickness of the stroke. Click this and go to this edit objects. Go to this stroke style and change it to pixel. Make it by 20. Okay, and let's duplicate for the inner. Press Ctrl D. Scale it down to this. And change the stroke width into 20. Duplicate again, press Ctrl D. And scale it up. Make it into 20 pixel again. Duplicate again, press Ctrl D and scale it up. Make it thinner, change it into 7. Scale up a little. Add more circle for the text later. Just duplicate again, press Ctrl D and scale it down. And change it into this yellow color, right click, just set stroke. And duplicate one more, press Ctrl D. Make it here. And let's type. And change the font into. You can download the font in the link description, thanks to the creator. Let's make it more thicker. As you see, it's only in one style, no bold version or heavy. So just make it thicker manually. Go to this stroke. Make it as black color. And change the width into 2 pixel. Then let's place the text to here. So select the text and this circle. Go to text, put on path. Now you see it's already in the circle. You can rotate it by clicking twice till you see this rotate icon, then rotate it. Let's make the size into 36. Rotate it a little again. Make it kern by 5. Rotate it a little. And add more. Make it thicker too with the stroke. Make it by 2 pixel. And let's put it on the circle. Select this text and the circle. Go to text, just put on path. Okay, just rotate it. You see it's upside down. It's not good to read. To flip that, click on the circle and press H on your keyboard to flip it horizontally. Okay, and rotate it again and make the size into same size, 36. Make the kern into 5. Okay, and then rotate it again and scale it down a little until it fit with the this to circle. Okay, the text is fit now in this. Let's add more object with the circle in here with the circle tool. Change it to black color. Place it on here and just duplicate, press Ctrl D. Place it on here. For the bottom, duplicate. Place it on here. And this, duplicate. Place it on here. Add more circle again in here. I'm gonna duplicate this. Press Ctrl D. And scale it up. Make it by 20 pixel. Okay, don't get confused. So we're gonna cut this line. Press B on your keyboard to active the Bezier tool and hold Ctrl Shift to lock the angle. Okay, so I'm gonna click this, make some rectangle. This and this. Now with this line selected and click this circle, go to path and choose cut path. So it will cut the line as the shape form. Now you can move it and delete it. These two, just delete it. Okay, now let's hide this yellow line for good preview. But if you remove the stroke, you won't be able to rotate it. Okay, so let's try. I'm removing this and these two. So if you want to rotate this again, you won't be able to rotate it. So it will rotate this text only and these two. Let me undo this. The solution is to make it a thinner line. Let's select these two and change it to pixel. Make it by 0.1. If you zoom in, you still can see the yellow line. That means you still can rotate it if something wrong. Just leave the yellow line before we remove it completely in the clean section. So it's make a good preview. Okay, now the last thing, add some text in the center. Let's type and change the font into Damien. You can download this font in the link description. Just scale it up. As you can see, the T and H are in not good space. So let's adjust the kern by selecting this T and H and make it by -5. So it's better. And just click twice until you see this arrow. Just drag it to the top. And move it to here. Then scale it up. Now we're going to make the extrusion effect. You can see in my previous video about how to create custom type design. Or just click in the screen card here. Let me change the color first to red so you can see clearly the duplicated objects. Let's duplicate this by pressing Ctrl D. Make the stroke as the black color. Remove the fill, right click, just remove fill. While the stroke in selection, move it to the lower back. And increase the width by 40 pixels. And make the stroke as the path, go to path and just stroke the path. You see this change to fill? That means it's already become path. Right, just clean these white areas on the stroke selected. Press F2, enter edit mode and select this, hit delete. Same thing with this. Can make it clean. And these two. Let's make some extrusion by duplicating this by pressing Ctrl D and move it to here. You should turn off this enable snapping. Move it to lower back. Okay, this is enough. And let's connect it with Bezier tool. Press B on your keyboard. Then let's connect it. Change the color into this and remove the stroke. Same thing with this. Okay, now make it union as the three objects. This, this, and this. Go to path and make it union. So the stroke become one union. Then let's clean the certain paint. Press F2 to enter the edit mode. I'm just gonna delete this. You see this? Let's clean this red text too. Click the red text and go to path. object to path, and just delete off this part. Duplicate the stroke again to make the white cut. Again, press Ctrl D to duplicate and make it as red. Just swap this and remove the stroke. Now go to path and choose this outset, or the shortcut is Ctrl plus right parenthesis. Just hit that shortcut a few times. I'm pressing 3 times. 1, 2, 3. Then move it to the lower back. Move this to the lower back. And this too. Now let's change this red into white color. Click this and this. And change it into the white color. Well, nice. You've made it so far. The last thing, don't forget to clean it, right? Just give it some background. Click this rectangle, and I'm changing it to this orange. Then let's turn on with enable snapping. Make it as the background and move it to the lower back. Let's convert this all circle into a path like this. Then go to path, just stroke path. Make it union because we want to subtract with this white. Go to path and click union. Now let's subtract the circle with this white stroke. Click this alter right stroke and the circle. Go to path and click difference. And let's subtract these white letters with this stroke. Right, so I'm just gonna select the letter and make it union. Go to path and click union. And select this, go to path and click difference. So let's clean this certain part. Okay, it's already clean. Just delete the background. If everything is done, don't forget to remove the yellow line and click this remove stroke. Convert the letter to path so it's not editable anymore. Click this and path, object to path. And let's apply the thickness that we done before. Go to path and click stroke to path. Same with this. So you're ready to export it as PNG and insert it into mockup with one color like the gold foil and many more. Thank you. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. There are many great handwritten and script fonts that you can buy for improving your design in the Bates logo concept. Don't forget to subscribe. Make sure you're an update about this Inkscape tutorial. I'm Zeke from Zeke Design. Create something good today.